Hello friends, welcome to Civil Twin. Today we are going to see about the thumb rule for civil engineering. By this video, we can easily calculate the quantity of materials required for construction purpose without any lengthy formula or calculations. This method is very useful for site engineers during construction purpose. The first rule is 1 meter cube of concrete volume is equal to 0.038 times the total area in square feet. Now we are going to calculate the concrete volume. We have taken the plot size of 15 meter feet in length and 10 meter feet in width. Now we are going to calculate an area. We already know the formula to calculate the area, that is length into breadth, so that we can get 150 square feet as an area. Now we are going to calculate the volume of concrete required for 150 square feet. We have already know the formula. The concrete volume required is equal to 0.038 times the total area, that is 150 square feet, so that we can get an amount of concrete volume required for 150 square feet, that is 5.7 meter cube. Now we are going to calculate the amount of steel required for the construction purpose. We have already framed two thumb rules for the steel calculation. One is for residential building and another one is for commercial building. For residential building, the amount of steel required per square feet is 4.5 to 4.75 kilogram. For commercial building, the amount of steel required is 5 to 5.5 kilogram per square feet. These two thumb rules are only an approximate method. To find out an accurate steel quantity of required for the construction purpose, we can follow the BM Dudha recommendation. The BM Dudha recommendation says that amount of steel required for slab is 1% of the total volume of concrete, for beam 2% of total volume of the concrete, for column 2.5% of the total volume of concrete, for footing 0.8% of the total volume of concrete. These four datas are the suggested by BM Dudha, which is an accurate method to find the amount of steel required. As per BM Dudha recommendation, the amount of steel required for the slab is equal to 1% of the total volume of concrete. Now we are going to see an example to calculate the amount of steel quantity required for slab construction. Here we have taken slab dimension as 4×4×0.150. By multiplying these three values, we can get the volume of concrete, that is 2.4 meter cube. The formula to calculate the steel quantity in kilogram is equal to volume of the concrete into density of the steel into 1%. If beam means 2% and for footing means 0.8%. We already know the value of the volume of concrete, that is 2.4 meter cube. The standard value density of the steel is 7850 and 1% is written as 1/100, that is 0.01. By multiplying these three factors, we can get the quantity of steel in kilogram, that is 188.5 kilogram. Now we are going to calculate the shuttering work. The shuttering work is calculated by the formula 6 times the quantity of the concrete or 2.5 times the plinth area. For example, we have taken the plinth area as 6 meter squared. The shuttering work is calculated by 2.5 as multiplied by 6 equal to 15 meter squared. The shuttering work is equal to 15 meter squared. Now we are going to calculate the quantity of the shuttering oil required. The quantity of the shuttering oil required is calculated by the formula 0.065 into shuttering area. This is the constant data, that is, for 15 meter squared of shuttering area, 1 liter of shuttering oil is consumed. It is very important data. Next, we are going to calculate the shuttering plywood. Here we have taken the plywood dimension as 2.44×1.22×0.012. To calculate the number of plywood sheets required, the formula used is 0.22 into shuttering area. Shuttering area is calculated by the formula length into breadth. The length of the plywood is taken as 2.44. The breadth of the plywood is 1.22, so that we can get the area as 3 meters squared. Now the amount of or number of plywood sheet required is equal to 0.22 into shuttering area, that is 3 meters squared. So we can get the shuttering plywood required as 0.66 meter squared. Next, we are going to see the amount of batten required for the construction purposes. Before that, we should know what is mean by batten. Batten is a long narrow piece of wood that is attached to the other piece of wood, which is used as a connecting tool. Now we are going to see the formula used to calculate the batten quantity. The formula used to calculate the batten quantity is 19.82 into number of plywood sheets. Next, we are going to calculate the amount of nails and the bending wire required. For 1 meter squared of shuttering work, the total amount of nail required is 75 grams. The bending wire required for 1 meter squared of shuttering is 75 grams. Next, we are going to see an important thumb rule, that is thumb rule for the calculation of amount of cement, sand and the coarse aggregate required for the construction purpose. First, for mixed is in M5, the amount of cement required is 2.82 bags, coarse aggregate required is 0.98 meter cube, the sand required is 0.49 meter cube. For mixed design M7.5, 3.48 cement bag is required, 0.97 meter cube coarse aggregate is required, 0.48 meter cube of sand is required. For M10 mixed design, 4.50 bags of cement is required, 0.90 meter cube coarse aggregate is required, 0.45 meter cube sand is required. And for M15 mixed design, 6.60 bags of cement is required, 0.88 meter cube of coarse aggregate is required, 0.44 meter cube of sand is required. For M20 mixed design, 8.40 bags of cement is required, 0.84 meter cube of coarse aggregate is required, 0.42 meter cube of sand is required. Now we are going to see the thumb rule for the brickworks. We have taken the two thickness of bricks, that is 230 mm and 115 mm, that is full size brick, this is half size brick. For 230 mm thickness of brick, the quantity of cement required in meter cube is 0.876, in bags is 25.4. For 115 mm thickness of brick, the quantity of cement required in meter cube is 0.216, in bags is 6.3213. Thank you for watching our video. For more video, subscribe our channel